Hey Jammers, welcome to Wild Explorers. Today, I feel like being an artiste. Did you know that watercolor painting has been around for thousands of years? Some watercolor paints date back as far as ancient Egypt. Today, you can buy watercolor paints, but artists used to make them. I think making them is more fun. Let me show you how to do it. Here's what you'll need. Baking soda, vinegar, corn syrup, corn starch, a bowl, whisk, food coloring, craft stick, and an ice cube tray. Awesome, let's get started. Put 1 cup of baking soda in your mixing bowl. Slowly add 3/4 cups of vinegar and watch it fizz. Whoop, it's fizzing a lot. Calm down, buddy. Then whisk together. It's so fizzy and bubbly. Add 1 cup of cornstarch and 2 tablespoons of corn syrup. And now we'll whisk some more. Stir it until all the ingredients are mixed together. It might take a while. Pour this, it's sticky, into your ice cube tray. This is the base of your paint. Now for the fun part. Let's add some color. Add food coloring to each section. You can make whatever colors you want with this paint. I like to mix colors. I'm gonna make a little bit of purple. And now we mix it together. I wonder how it's gonna look like when it's done. And now we wait. The paint needs to harden. Ta-da! Look at them, they're so colorful and cool. Now, you can create whatever you want. I think I'll make a rainbow. Ta-da! Look at all the cool things you can make with these paints. To keep learning, go to animaljam.com and don't forget to play wild. Are you excited for the Feast of Thanks? I know I am. It's such a great time in Jama. Let's celebrate by making some glitter pumpkins. Did you know that thousands of years ago, people decorated with glitter? People a long time ago used mica flakes, a type of rock, to make their art sparkly and pretty. Today, glitter is usually made out of plastic. To make a glitter pumpkin, you will need some newspaper, some pumpkins, glitter and some bowls, a paintbrush and glue, and that's it. First, cover your area with newspaper so you can clean up easily. Maybe just one more. All right. Put some glitter in a bowl. You can even mix a few types of glitter together. Next, choose your pumpkin. Decide if you want to do stripes, or cover the whole thing. I'm gonna do polka dots. Then put some glue on your pumpkin. I like to spread mine around with a paintbrush. Now it's sparkle time. Put glitter on your glue. Let's make this one black. It looks so sparkly. Now let your pumpkin dry. It's done! Tap the extra glitter off your pumpkin. And you'll have a beautiful thing to keep or give to a friend. There are so many ways to decorate your glitter pumpkins. For more pumpkin fun, visit animaljam.com and don't forget to play wild. Hey Jammers, today we're gonna get crafty with an ancient art form. Paper marbling. The name refers to the finished product. The pattern on the paper looks like marble, a type of rock. The oldest form of paper marbling was invented in Japan. Cool, huh? They did it by dropping ink into water and then fanning it to make awesome patterns, like these. Then they dipped paper in to pick up the ink, and it looks super cool. Other countries developed their own style of paper marbling. It became an art form in places like Turkey and Italy. Every piece of paper marbling is a masterpiece because it's got its own unique style. Every piece that's created is amazing. Let's try it out. To marble your own paper at home, you will need paper towels, a dish of some sort, a spoon, shaving cream, food coloring, a ruler, and any sort of toothpick things, and of course, paper. Get started by putting a few paper towels down. You'll need them a little later. Fill the dish with shaving cream. Oh, it's going haywire! There we go. Oh yeah. Now I'm gonna add a few drops of food coloring to add a lot of color and cool patterns. There we go. Ooh, look at that pretty blue. Oh, it looks so cool. Let's do a little bit of yellow. Yeah, yellow will be good. Ooh, it's looking so pretty. All right, I'm going to take some of the toothpicks and just like make a cool pattern sort of, like maybe some more darker blue right here, like just like little spots of darker blue. So like on the paper, it'll be like dark swirls of blue. All right. Now for the final moment. Place your paper on the marble shaving cream. Press it down really hard. Take the paper off the shaving cream and put it on your paper towels. You don't really want the shaving cream on there, else it's gonna like get really soggy. So we're just gonna push this off with the ruler. So grab your ruler, just hold onto the paper and swoosh it off like this. Oh my gosh, it looks so cool! Look at that, oh my gosh. Now let it dry. When it's done, you can write an awesome letter to a friend or even just make a beautiful piece of art. I think I'm gonna frame this one and hang it up in my tent. For more fun stuff like this, visit animaljam.com and don't forget to play wild! Hey, Jammers, welcome to Wild Explorers. Today, I'm working on a super fun craft that involves wires and motors and the third thing and, ooh, googly eyes. We got some awesome googly eyes going on here. Oh, we also might need a little bit of dancing to get our mood going. That's right, I did the robot. Well, I actually didn't do the robot, I just did this. Which isn't really the robot. But I really don't know how to do the robot. But anyways, I'm making an awesome coloring robot. But first, a joke. Why was the robot grumpy? Because someone kept pushing his buttons. He's gonna get angry at me now. Anyway, here's what you need to make your very own robot at home. And this one I won't push his buttons. You're going to need a plastic cup of some sort and some tape, some awesome markers, some AA batteries, some clippy thingies, some weird motors, and a battery holder, some glue sticks, some googly eyes, because googly eyes make everything better, some scissors, and some other art supplies if you'd like them. Whew, that was a lot of stuff. Here's how to make it. Start by testing your motor, just to make sure it works. You don't wanna like set up your robot and then it's like not working. That'd be like a huge disappointment. Yay, it works. Now start building. Take the motor and the battery to the top of the container. You may notice the small rotating part sticking out from the motor. Stick a piece of hot glue stick there if you'd like. To make your robot draw, attach the markers to the container. Remove the marker caps and set on a piece of paper. Oh, yes, before I forget, we need some googly eyes, because googly eyes, as I said, make everything better. I'm a Cyclops! Put the other battery in and watch what happens. Whoa, see, it goes crazy! Now it should sort of move. Move it on the table and it's just gonna make like the best art piece ever. His little eyes are googling.
Hello, I'm Mr. Cup Dude.
Now when your art piece is done, take out one battery if you can. This is so cool, I can't wait to keep experimenting. For more fun ideas, visit animaljam.com and don't forget to say wow. Now if you'll excuse me, I have to power down for a bit.